Hello friends, today we will study second video of pathogen induced diseases in animals and plants. Streptomyces. For Streptomyces, this is the best recognized genus of the family Streptomycetaceae and is widely distributed in soils. Slender coenocytic filaments of 0.5 to 2.0 mm in diameter produce aerial mycelium from chains of three to many spores in a chain. Slow-growing gram-positive Streptomyces species are producers of antibiotics and a variety of color pigments. S. scabies is pathogenic. Mycoplasmas and plant diseases. Let's know about mycoplasmas and plant diseases. Mycoplasmas, that means fungus forms. Free living or parasitic organisms are not new to microbiologist and veterinary pathologist. Mycoplasma mycoides was cultured in vitro some 100 years ago in Pasteur's laboratory from animals suffering from bovine pleuropneumonia. Later on, similar types of organisms were isolated from a number of other animals and birds, and these were named pleuropneumonia-like organisms. Borel, et al. In 1910, gave the first binomial to these organisms and called them Streptococcus mycoid, and later they were put under the genus Mycoplasma and Borreliomyces. Since Streptococcus was an algal genus, the editorial board of the International Building and Bacterial Nomenclature and Taxonomy discarded the genus Streptococcus and recommended the use of either of the other two genera. Since 1967, mycoplasmas have been associated with as many as 80 plant diseases based on, first is, the constant presence of a mycoplasma-like organism in the phloem of diseased plants and their complete absence from healthy plants. The presence of similar microorganisms in insect vectors which carry the infectious organisms and absence of MLO from non-infective individuals. The recovery of plants after the application of tetracyclines and the reappearance of MLO when the disease recurs. The disappearance of MLO from the plants and vectors which have been cured by heat therapy. Attempts were made in many laboratories to obtain cell-free cultures of the various MLOs. Spiroplasma citri, the causal agent of citrus stubborn disease, was obtained in pure culture by Saglio et al. In 1971 and by Fudi Allah et al. In 1972. It took 2 to 3 years more before definite evidence was obtained and that S. citri is the causal agent of the stubborn diseases. These organisms were called mycoplasma-like organisms because of their superficial resemblance to mycoplasmas. It was later shown that there are not mycoplasmas, although all belong to the class Molluscus, order Mycoplasmatales of prokaryotes. The true nature of mycoplasma-like organism, now called as phytoplasmas, is still not certain. At the moment, phytoplasmas are considered to belong to the class Molluscus, which include true mycoplasmas, but no family or genus name has been assigned to them. The citrus stubborn and the corn stunt organisms are placed in the genus Spiroplasma in the class Molluscus. Spiroplasmas are helical molecules. Spiroplasmas are cells that vary in shape from spherical or slightly ovoid, 100 to 240 nanometer or larger in diameter, to helical and branched non-helical filaments. They lack a true cell wall and are surrounded by a unit membrane. The helical filaments are motile, moving by a rapid rotatory or screw-like motion. There are no flagella. Spiroplasma colonies on agar media have a typical fried egg appearance and are around 0.2 mm in diameter. Two distinct groups of spiroplasmas have been reported to cause disease in plants. One group, represented by corn stunt spiroplasma, has a narrow host range limited only to species of Gia. The other group, represented by Spiroplasma citri, has a much wider range, host range, and has been found to cause stubborn diseases in citrus as well as in crucifers and other crop plants. Tully and Whitcomb have reviewed the work on spiroplasmas. More than 80 plant diseases, grafts, or insect transmissible with characteristic symptoms such as abnormalities in floral and vegetative parts, allowing proliferation of axillary buds, reduction in leaf lamina, general stunting, and so on, have been reported to be due to mycoplasmas-like bodies. Alfalfa witches, broom, brinjal leaf, brinjal little leaf, citrus tuber, clover, phyllodi, cucumber phyllodi, legume little leaf, papaya bunchy top, peanut witch's broom, potato witch's broom, sandal spike, sesam pylori, sugarcane grassy shoot are some examples. Diseases caused by plant parasitic nematodes. Nematodes are the most highly developed two of the pseudocolometasa, widely present in the soil, freshwater, and marine water. Nematodes are the only plant parasites belonging to the animal kingdom which are studied in plant pathology. Nematodes, sometimes called ill-worms, are worm-like in appearance but quite distinct taxonomically from the true worms. Numerous species of nematodes attack and parasitize man and animals and cause various diseases. Several hundred species are known to feed on living plants as parasites and cause a variety of plant diseases. Crompton in 1966 gave a general account of nematodes. Wallace published one of the most interesting works on the biology of plant parasitic nematodes in 1963. Swamp and Seshadri in 1974 reviewed nematology in India. Khan has discussed the methods of controlling nematodes. Nematodes are parasites of plants. Their ecology and the process of infection were discussed by Dropkin in 1977. Somewhat recent literature on nematodes as plant pathogens and their biology, ecology, pathology control includes that by Sita Ramaya in 1984. Plant parasitic Nematodes of India, Swarup in 1990, Nematode Microorganism Interaction, Khan and Khan in 1993, Nematode Problem of Vegetables, Sita Ramaya and Singh in 1993, Handbook of Plant Nematology, Singh and Sitaram in 1994, Plant pathogen, that is the nematodes and the four major species of root knot nematodes, current states and management by Khan in 1994. The characteristic features of subclass Cicimentae are excretory canals present, terminal excretory duct, cuticularized, caudal glands absent, plasmids usually present, amphids usually minute, pore-like and cephalic in position, sensory organs papilloid, seldom setose, hypodermal glands absent, male with or without caudal allele. Plant and animal diseases. Plant diseases. Most plant diseases are caused by fungi, bacteria and viruses, although the term disease is usually used only for the destruction of leaf plants. The action of dry rot and rotting of harvested crops in storage or transport is similar to the rot of growing plants. Both are caused by bacteria and fungi. Any environmental factor that favors the growth of parasites or disease transmitters, or that is unfavorable to the growth of the plants, will lead to increased in the likelihood of infection and the amount of destruction caused by parasitic disease. Parasitic diseases are spread by dissemination of the agent itself or of the reproductive structures. Wind, rain, insects, humans and other animals may provide the means for dissemination. Most names for plant diseases are descriptive of the physical appearance of the affected plant. Example, blight means a rapid death of foliage, blossom or whole plant. Leaf spot, fruit spot, scab and stem, canker, localized death of an organism, wilt, loss of turgor, gall, witch's broom, stunting and leaf caul, mosaic and yellows resulting from chlorosis or lack of chlorophyll. Many of these abnormalities are caused by different agents on different plants. When parasites are involved, each individual parasite usually invades only certain plant species and specific organs. Dodge elm disease, chestnut blight, rust, smut, certain mildews and ergot are caused by various fungi. Club root diseases are caused by slime molds and water molds cause downy mildew, blue mold of tobacco and sudden oak death. Sudden oak death caused by Phytophthora ramorum was identified in 1995 in California, where it caused the death of many oaks. The disease, which affects many plant species besides oaks, has since been found in Oregon and is also found in Europe. There was identified in 1993 in Germany, where it affected rhododendrons and viburnums. The water mold P. infestans was the cause of the late blight of potatoes that resulted in the Great Potato Famine in Ireland. Both slime molds and water molds are now usually considered protists rather than fungi. Most mosaic diseases and many other types of chlorosis are caused by viruses. Plant diseases are more often classified by their symptoms than by the agent of disease, because the discovery of microscopic agents such as bacteria dates only from the 19th century. The Irish potato blight stimulated the development of plant pathology. The identification of tobacco mosaic virus in 1892 was the starting point of all modern knowledge about viruses. Now let's know about crown gall disease. It is the common plant disease caused by the soil-borne bacterium Agrobacterium tumefaciens. It is found throughout the world and occurs on many woody shrubs and herbaceous plants, including grapes, raspberries, stone fruits and roses. Crown gall can be identified by the large deserted growths that appear between the root and trunk of a plant just above soil level. Plants with several galls may be unable to move water and nutrients of the trunk and become weakened, stunted and unproductive. Young plants can be killed by developing gall tissues. Mosaic virus. Let's know about mosaic virus. Affecting a wide variety of plants, including roses, beans, tobacco, tomatoes, potatoes and peppers, mosaic is a viral disease found throughout the United States. Plant viruses can be difficult to detect as symptoms look similar to several nutrient deficiencies. Yellow strips or spots on foliage, wrinkled or curled leaves, stunted growth and reduced yields. Infected fruit appears molted and develops raised wilty areas. Mosaic virus overwinters on perennial weeds and is spread by insects that feed on them. Aphids, leafhoppers, White flies and cucumber beetles are common carriers of this disease. Cutting or divisions from infested plants will also carry the virus. Rust. These are more than 5,000 unknown species of rust on plants. Common rust is a fungal disease that affects roses, snapdragons, bluegrass, and woody perennials. It is most often found on mature plants where symptoms appear primarily on the surface of lower leaves. Rust diseases are favored by 4 to 8 hours of lower light intensity, warm temperatures and moisture, high humidity, heavy dew or light rain, followed by 8 to 16 hours of high light intensity, high temperature and slow drying of leaf surfaces. Black spores are visible on leaves and stems in fall and overwinter inside infected stems, which are distinguished by dark, corky blotches at points of infection. The spores are spread by wind or by water splashing back onto foliage. Now, let's know about blossom end rot. Blossom end rot disease. A serious disorder of tomato, pepper, cucumber and eggplant blossom end rot is an environmental problem caused by insufficient levels of calcium during fruit formation. This common garden disease is often brought on by rapid growth from too much fertilizer, high salt levels, drought or uneven soil moisture. Blossom end rot occurs on both green and ripe fruits and is identified by water-soaked areas that mature into sunken brown leathery spots on the blossom end. In many cases, secondary pathogens which appear as a black, fuzzy-like growth attack the affected area and cause complete rotting of the fruit. Blossom end rot will not spread from plant to plant. Club root. Affecting members of the cabbage family, club root is a serious plant disease in North America. It is caused by the soil-borne fungus Plasmodiophora brassica, which infects susceptible plant through root hairs. Diseased roots become misshapen and deformed, often cracking and rotting. As a result, plants have difficulty absorbing water and nutrients properly. Plants may grow slowly and wilt during the heat of the day. Plants often revive during cool nights. Outer leaves eventually turn yellow or brown. Club root will reduce yields and can cause total plant loss. Fungal spores can be spread by water and garden tools. Disease development can occur over a wide range of conditions, but is favored by excessive moisture, low soil pH and soil temperatures between 64 and 77 degrees. If spores can survive in the soil for as many as 10 years. Early blight. Let's know about early blight disease. It is common on tomato and potato plants. Early blight is caused by the fungus Alternaria solani and occurs throughout the United States. It first appears on the lower, older leaves as small brown spots with concentric rings that form a bullseye pattern. As the disease matures, it spreads outward on the leaf surface, causing it to turn yellow, wither and die. Eventually, the stem, fruit and upper portion of the plant will be infected. Crops can be severely damaged. Early blight overwinters on infected plant tissue and is spread by splashing rain, irrigation, insects and garden tools. The disease is also carried on tomato seeds and in potato tubers. In spite of its name, early blight can occur anytime throughout the growing season. High temperatures and wet, humid conditions promote its rapid spread. In many cases, poorly nourished or stressed plants are attacked. Grey mold, found on a wide range of plants. Grey mold is a fungal disease that travels quickly through gardens, especially during damp, cool to mild weather. It can be identified as grayish colored, soft, mossy spots on leaves, stems, flowers, and on produce. Spots may become covered with a coating of gray fungus spores, especially if humidity is high. Fruits or plants shrivel and rot and often develop black, stone-like sclerotia under rotted plant parts. Gray mold is often found near the soil surface or in the densest areas of the plant canopy. It develops on wilted flowers first, then spreads quickly to other parts of the plant. The disease may also occur in storage, causing rotting of harvested fruits and vegetables. Potato scab. Let's know about the disease potato scab. A common tuber disease that occurs wherever potatoes are grown. Potato scab appears as superficial dark brown pithy patches that may be raised and warty. These lesions may affect just a small portion of the tuber surface or may completely cover it. Sometimes the raised portions are in broken concentric rings. Potato scab is caused by the bacteria-like organism Streptomyces scabies that overwinters in fallen leaves and in the soil. The organism can survive indefinitely in slightly alkaline soil, but is relatively scarce in highly acid soils. It is transmitted to plants by infected seed tubers, wind, and water. Leaf spot. Infected plants have brown or black water-soaked spots on the foliage, sometimes with a yellow halo, usually uniform in size. The spots enlarge and will run together under wet conditions. Under dry conditions, the spots have a speckled appearance. As spots become more numerous, entire leaves may yellow, wither, and drop. Members of Prunus family, that means stone fruits including cherry, plum, almond, apricot, and peach, are particularly susceptible to bacterial leaf spot. The fruit may appear spotted or have sunken brown areas. Bacterial leaf spot will also attack tomato and pepper crops in vegetable gardens. Bacterial leaf spot will also infect some annual and perennial flowering plants, including geraniums, zinnias, purple cane flowers, and black-eyed succulents. Fungal leaf spot will infect aspen and poplar trees. Leaf spot will also cause problems for strawberry plants. Let's know about animal diseases. Animal diseases that people can catch are called zoonoses. Many diseases affected humans can be traced to animals or animal products. You can get a disease directly from an animal or indirectly through the environment. Let's know about most notifiable animal diseases. First is anthrax. Anthrax is a contagious, often fatal, potential zoonotal notifiable animal disease caused by the bacterium Bacillus anthracis. Especially herbivorous farm and breeding animals are affected. Main sources of infection are the spores of B. anthracis ingested by the animals with the feed. Depending on the entrance pathway, cutaneous, pulmonary, or intestinal anthrax may occur. The disease preferentially occurs in warmer climate zones. In Germany, it only occurs sporadically. Risk areas are plain tracts, which are subject to frequent flooding, Further sources of infection are raw material of animal origin imported from other countries, such as dried hides and skins of goat, sheep, cattle and horses, as well as the hair, wool or pig bristles gained from these animals. African horse. Second is African horse sickness. AHS is a notifiable seasonal virus infection of or toad ungulated, causing paracute and acute disease predominantly in equids. The etiologic agent is a double-stranded RNA virus in the Orbivirus virus genus. Upon first introduction of the virus into a previously free region, lethality in infected horses can be as high as 95%, significantly impacting local economies. Disease is most severe in horses but only mild in horse or donkey hybrids and donkeys. Dogs can develop disease after ingesting infected horse flesh. African swine fever, ASF. Let's know about the disease. African swine fever is one of the most important and complex diseases affecting pigs. Due to its socio-economic impact, the disease is notifiable to the World Organization of Animal Health. It is caused by a large DNA virus belonging to the family Aspergillus genus virus. Vertebrate hosts are only pigs, but the transmission cycle can involve soft ticks of the gene Ornithoderus, in which the virus can replicate. Thus, African swine fever virus is the only known virus with a DNA genome that can be classified as arthropod-borne virus. Now, let's know about next disease. Brucellosis species infection. It is an infectious disease caused by bacteria of the genus Brucella. As the pathogen can be transmitted to humans by cattle, pigs and sheep and goat, as well as to a limited extent by dogs. Brucellosis is a zoonotic disease. Main symptoms of brucellosis in animals are abort, premature birth or birth of death, weak or poorly developed animals. Male animals often develop inflammatory changes of the genital tract, especially testes and epididymis. Foot and mouth disease. Let's know about foot and mouth disease. Swine vesicle disease and vesicular somatitis. Foot and mouth disease, FMD, is a highly contagious disease of cloven-hoofed animals and occurs in many non-European countries. The disease is characterized by high fever that declines rapidly after 2 to 3 days, and the development of vesicles and erosions inside the mouth and on the feet. For adult animals, the disease usually is not fatal, but the animals may suffer long-lasting weight loss and in cows, milk production can decline significantly. In young animals, there may be a high mortality due to myocarditis. Due to its potentially catastrophic effects, FMD still is one of the most important animal diseases. The extreme contagiousness of the disease requires comprehensive movement restrictions and stamping out measures to control an outbreak, causing high economic losses. Rabies, one of the oldest known viral zoonotic diseases, diseases that are transmissible from animals to humans, occurs worldwide and is an internationally notifiable disease. According to estimations of the WHO, several 10,000 humans die from this disease every year, especially in the poorer countries of Africa and Asia. Therefore, it is also considered a neglected zoonosis. Single stranded RNA viruses of negative polarity are the causative agent of rabies and belong to the genus Lyssa virus of the family Rhabdoviridae in the order Mononegaviral. Tuberculosis. It is an infectious disease caused by mycobacteria of the Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex. It is transmissible between humans and animals and is therefore considered a zoonotic disease. Now come to Mycobacteria. Bacteria of the genus Mycobacterium are non-motile, in most cases short bacilli, which often form aggregates. In principle, they can be stained according to gram. However, due to their strong stability against acids, they can be differentiated from other bacterial species by specific staining methods. Example, according to Zill Nelson, Mycobacterium grow under aerobic conditions and are characterized by long generation times, that is 2 to 20 hours. So called fast growing mycobacteria take 3 to 5 days, slow growing 4 to 6 weeks, and Mycobacterium avium species paratuberculosis even 3 months or more to form colonies. Now come to next diseases, sheeppox and goatpox disease. Sheeppox and goatpox are highly contagious diseases of small ruminants caused by caprypox viruses. They are notifiable acute diseases characterized by typical generalized skin lesions. Sheeppox and goatpox viruses are morphologically indistinguishable. Genetic recombination between them can occur. They are transmitted by direct contact with infected animals and have a high tenacity. Initial clinical symptoms are fever, increased salivation, and nasal and ocular discharge. Within a few days, papules, nodules, and vesicles appear on the head, in the genital area, and on the udder. The lesions can take up to 6 weeks to heal. High mortality can occur in lambs when mucosal surface of the alimentary and respiratory tracts are severely affected. Massive lesions in these areas can give rise to secondary bacterial infection. Now, let's know about cell fusion. It is an important cellular process in which several unicellular cells combine to form a multinuclear cell, known as a syncytium. Cell fusion occurs during differentiation of muscle, bone and trophoblast cells during embryogenesis and during morphogenesis. Cell fusion is a necessary event in the maturation of cells so that they maintain their specific function throughout growth. Two types of cell fusion. There are two different types of cell fusion that can occur. These two types include homotypic and heterotypic cell fusion. Homotypic cell fusion occurs between cells of the same type. An example of this would be osteoclast and myofibers being fused together. Whenever the two nuclei merge, a synchorion is produced. The cell fusion normally occurs with nuclear fusion, but in the absence of nuclear fusion, the cell would be described as a binucleated heterokaryon. A heterokaryon is the melding of two or more cells into one, and it may reproduce itself for several generations. Heterotypic cell fusion occurs between cells of different types, making it the exact opposite of homotypic cell fusion. The result of this fusion is also a synchorion produced by the merging of the nuclei and a binucleated heterokaryon in the absence of nuclear fusion. An example of this would be BMDCs being fused with parenchymatous organs. Three methods for fusing cells. There are three methods that cell biologists used to fuse cells. These three include electrical cell fusion, polyethylene glycol cell fusion, and Sendai virus induced cell fusion. Electric cell fusion is an essential step in some of the most innovative methods in modern biology. This method begins when two cells are brought into contact by dielectrophoresis. Dielectrophoresis uses a high frequency alternating current, unlike electrophoresis in which a direct current is applied. Once the cells are brought together, a pulsed voltage is applied. The pulse voltage causes the cell membrane to permeate, and subsequent combining of the membranes and the cells then fuse. After this alternative to permeate and subsequent combining of the membranes and the cells then fuse. After this alternative voltage is applied for a brief period of time to stabilize the process. The result of this is that the cytoplasm has mixed together and the cell membrane has completely fused. All that remains separate is the nuclei, which will fuse at a later time within the cell, making the result a heterokaryon cell. Polyethylene glycol cell fusion is the simplest but most toxic way to fuse cells. In this type of cell fusion, polyethylene glycol (PEG) acts as a dehydrating agent and fuses not only plasma membranes but also intracellular membranes. This leads to cell fusion, since PEG induces cell agglutination and the cell-to-cell contact. Though this type of cell fusion is the most widely used, it still has downfalls. Oftentimes, PEG can cause uncontrollable fusion of multiple cells, leading to the appearance of giant polykaryons. Also, standard PEG cell fusion is poorly reproducible, and different types of cells have various fusion susceptibilities. This type of cell fusion is widely used for the production of somatic cell hybrids and for the nuclear transfer in mammalian cloning. Sendai virus-induced cell fusion occurs in four different temperature stages during the first stage, which lasts no longer than 10 minutes. Viral adsorption takes place, and the absorbed virus can be inhibited by viral antibodies. The second stage, which is 20 minutes, is pH-dependent, and an addition of viral antiserum can still inhibit ultimate fusion. In the third antibody refractory stage, viral envelope constituents remain detectable on the surface of cells. During the fourth stage, cell fusion becomes evident, and HA neura minidase and fusion factor begin to disappear. The first and second stages are the only two that are pH dependent. Cell fusion for human therapy. Alternative forms of restoring organ function and replacing damaged cells are needed, with donor organs and tissue for transplantation being so scarce. It is because of the scarcity that biologists have begun considering the potential for therapeutic cell fusion. Biologists have been discussing implications of the observation that cell fusion can occur with restorative effects following tissue damage or cell transplantation. Though using cell fusion for this is being talked about the work done, there are still many changes those who wish to implement cell fusion as a therapeutic tool face. These challenges include choosing the best cells to use for the reproductive fusion, determining the best way to introduce the chosen cells into the desired tissue, discovering methods to increase the incidence is in cell fusion, and ensuring that the resulting fusion products will function properly. If these challenges can be overcome, then cell fusion may have therapeutic potential. Other uses. Let's know about the other uses to study the control of cell division and gene expression. Next is to investigate malignant transformation. Third is to obtain viral application. Fourth is gene and chromosome mapping. Fifth is for production of monoclonal antibodies by producing hybridoma technology. Sixth is for production of induced stem cells. Seven is to assess protein shuttling in what is known as a heterokaryon fusion assay. Thank you.